Hey guys, today we are on this Gree inverter system. This is my first visit out here after we installed it, and I'm looking forward to seeing how it's doing. Look for any error codes, and I'm gonna show you all how to put it through defrost. At least I hope to. Here we go. This just, if I'm not mistaken, it slides up, or it slides up or down, one or the other. One, two, three, four of them. Well, I know it slides into grooves, I think it slides down. And that's cold. That is cold air coming out right now. Well, so you have to push this down to get it out, which was easier said than done. Alright, we have no error codes, it just says ohm, which is good. It is producing a little bit of heat. Let's check our amp draw on this, so y'all can see what typical amp draw on this is. We're pulling 8.88 amps, and that is very all right. Let's get I don't remember if I have to have an adapter. Yeah, I do. Okay, it has ramped up. We're up to 14.7 amps. Let's see if I have those. That's one. I need to put me a little Schrader in there, don't I? Come on. .351 on my head pressure. Now that's nice and hot. 14.5 amps. Alright. Now let's see if we can figure out how to put this through defrost. This is buried down in the service manual, so it's not exactly obvious how to do this. Press and hold S1. About 5 seconds. All right, now that's flashing. Press S1 to switch to 06. All right, that's 5 06. Okay, short press SW2. Did it not take it? Alright, this is what it says. Press and hold S1 for about 5 seconds to enter first level menu of the debugging mode. The outdoor unit mainboard LED displayer flashes. On the first level menu, press S1 to switch various functions. After switching to 06, short press SW2 or SW3 to enter forced defrost mode. On means open. Off means close. Then short press the S1 to save. If no operation is performed within 10 seconds, the debugging mode interface will be exited. As y'all see, I'm having trouble getting it on 6. It says, once you get under first level menu, short press maybe I'm doing it wrong. Six. Okay, I was pressing the wrong button. It went straight to on. On means open, off means closed. All right, this is just a debugging mode. I don't know how to get it to force into defrost. Force defrost control. It ain't doing what I'm trying to do. Let me try to do it and see if we can't make it happen. Right, so I was unable to make it go into defrost. I'll contact tech support and see if I was doing something wrong. But it says to try to get this where y'all can see. It says to hold this SW1 until it flashes and then move it. Press SW1 until you get to 6, and then short press SW2 or 3. And see how it says on right there? I'm fixing to put one of these in at my house, so I'll have a lot more time to play with it and try to figure out how to do that. Okay, so this is 343 PSI in that pipe. Is 163 degrees. Sitting in front of that is cold. Oh my Lord, it's cold. So yeah, we're running in heat. That amp draw right there. That is pretty much on high speed. It is not high, it's close to it, because that's a relatively high pressure for heat. Alright, that's producing some good heat. Let's just open her up and take a look. I just put 5 kW in it. Man, how many screws are in this door? All right, it has not been getting wet. Let me take a amp draw real quick. While I'm down here, I gotta do this filter. We got 1.64 amps. So we have 14.4 outside. So 16 amps is a typical running amperage. So without the heat strip, you can run this off a 30 amp breaker, the whole system, and it don't need heat strips. Well, I was never able to get that thing to go through defrost. First, I did it by the book, and then I just started punching all kinds of things to try to see if I can make it happen. And then I went back by the book again, and it would just say on, which means closed. And if it says OF, that means open. And then in the instructions, it's talking about debugging. I didn't want to debug anything. I wanted to force it into defrost, but I couldn't do that. You did see typical amp draws on that 3-ton system. So 16 amps at high speed. I'm saying 16 amps for the air handler and the condenser at high speed. So that's pretty good. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll catch you on the next one.